Well, welcome to the first meeting of session 6 of the Delegated Power and Law Reform Committee. I am Bill Kidd, MSP, and as the oldest member, I'm told, of the committee, I have the pleasure of convening this meeting for the first 2 items of business. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome all members, and I look forward to working with you on this committee. As we are meeting online, I appreciate it will be more challenging for members to indicate agreement to the items being discussed. So can I therefore ask you to raise your hand if you're not consent with any of the questions being put, or if you wish to speak about the item. Before we move to the first item on the agenda, I would like to remind everyone present to switch mobile phones to silent if you haven't already done so. Okay, thank you. And the first item of business is declaration of interest. In accordance with Section 3 of the Code of Conduct, I invite members to declare any interest relevant to the remit of the committee, and I'll begin with myself before asking each member in turn. So firstly, I state that I have no relevant interest to declare. I will now turn to each member and ask them to invite them to declare any interests. And firstly, can I ask Craig Hoy? Craig.
Thank you, Mr. Kidd. Can I just declare that I'm a member of East Lothian Council?
Thank you very much indeed. Thanks for that, Craig Hoy. Stuart McMillan.
Thank you, Bill. I have no relevant interest.
Thank you also, Stuart McMillan. Graeme Simpson, please.
Thanks very much. I don't have any relevant interest to declare either.
Thank you very much, Graeme Simpson. And Paul Sweeney, please.
Thanks, Chair. I don't have any relevant interest to declare.
Well, thank you all very much indeed. Thanks, Paul Sweeney. Okay then, so that means we can move to agenda item 2, which is choice of convener. And the Parliament has agreed that only members of the Scottish National Party are eligible for nomination as convener of this committee in this session. Can I therefore ask for a nomination for this role, please?
I will nominate Stuart McMillan to be convener.
Thank you very much, Graeme Simpson. So there's a nomination for Stuart McMillan to be convener. Does the committee agree to appoint Stuart McMillan as convener of the DPLR committee? One member has indicated that they are not content, and so we are agreed. So I'd like to congratulate Stuart McMillan on his appointment. I am now going to vacate the chair and hand over to Stuart. Stuart McMillan, please.
Thank you very much for that, Bill, and thank you very much, colleagues, for your support in the day of me becoming the convener of this committee. Just before we do move on to item 3, I would like to certainly say, at least to congratulate and thank the previous committee on session 5 for the outstanding work that they undertook in the DPLR committee, and in particular, I'd like to thank Bill Bowman, the previous convener of the committee, for his excellent stewardship, certainly when he became the convener. And prior to Bill, clearly it was Graeme Simpson as well. So thank you to you also, Graeme. Now we move on to agenda item number 3, and that's the choice of the deputy convener. The Parliament has agreed that only members of the Scottish National Party are eligible for nomination as deputy convener of the committee. And that being the case, I seek nominations for the position of deputy convener. I would like to nominate Bill Kidd to become the deputy convener of the DPLR committee. And does the committee agree to Bill Kidd becoming the deputy convener? No member has indicated that they are not content, so we are agreed. So congratulations, Bill, on your appointment as deputy convener of the DPLR committee.
Thank you, colleagues. Thank you very much indeed.
The next item of business is to decide on whether to take item 9 in private. Is the committee content to take item 9 in private? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, so we are agreed. The next item of business is the consideration of instruments subject to the made affirmative procedure, and no points have been raised on SSIs 2021-224, 227, 230, 237, 238 and 242. Is the committee content with these instruments?
Convener, I am content within the remit of this committee. One of these instruments, which is amendment number 28, relates to the travel restrictions from Scotland to Manchester. And I think it's important that people realise that under the remit of this committee, there are no grounds for this committee to challenge that. I have reservations about that particular amendment on a technical level. I think it's going to be very difficult, if not impossible, to enforce. But I will have the opportunity to raise questions about that later. So it's just if people are watching and they're wondering why on earth aren't they saying anything about it, it's because under the terms of our committee that we are restricted in what we, on the grounds that we can actually push back on certain regulations. That's the reason. Parliament will have a chance to question ministers later this afternoon.
Sure, no problem. Thank you for that. Thank you very much for that, Mr. Simpson. And yes, so Mr. Simpson has a question today in talkable questions. So I'm not sure if there was a delay in the broadcasting there. So Mr. Simpson has a question, a topical question today on this particular issue. So no member has indicated that they are not content, notwithstanding obviously what Mr. Simpson indicated. And so are we agreed with these instruments? Thank you. Agenda item number six, we are considering instruments subject to the negative procedure. An issue has been raised on SSI 221-236, which is the Coronavirus Scotland Act 2020, early expiry of provisions number 2, Regulations 2021. The instrument brings forward the expiry date of 3 provisions in the Coronavirus Scotland Act 2020, affecting the work of the Parole Board for Scotland. It was laid on the 10th of June 2021 and came into force on the 14th of June 2021. As it was laid less than 28 days before it came into force, it is in breach of Section 28(2) of the Interpretation and Legislative Reform Scotland Act 2010, which requires that negative instruments are laid at least 28 days before they come into force, not counting recess periods of more than 4 days. The committee wished to draw the instrument to the attention of the Parliament under Reporting Ground J, as it has been laid less than 28 days before coming into force and therefore has breached the laying requirements under the 2010 Act. And at the same time, does the committee wish to note that it has satisfied the explanation provided for failure to comply with the laying requirements? No member has indicated that they are not content or that they wish to speak, and therefore so we are agreed. Also, under this agenda item, no points have been raised on SSIs 2021, 210, 214, 220, 221, 222 and 225. Is the committee content with these instruments? Yes, Graeme.
I'm sorry to be awkward, but I'm just monitoring the chat box and Mr. Sweeney had indicated he wanted to come in on a previous item. Now it may be he's struggling with this platform, and that's understandable. But I just wonder if you, as convener, would wish to check if Mr. Sweeney did want to say anything.
Yeah. Yes. Thank you for that, Mr. Simpson. I see that point now. So I will go back to the previous agenda item number 5. So, Mr. Sweeney.
Thank you, Chair. Sorry for the confusion there. I just want to raise a concern about the potential deficiency of the provision in respect of consumer rights. It's been understood that Trainline have said the government has to advise the rail industry that only essential passengers can travel and that non-essential travellers should be refunded. Given the lack of provision within the SSI, it could potentially cause significant financial detriment. I wonder if that's a concern we ought to raise with the government.
It's not a, my understanding would be that it's not a technical matter that the committee would look at, but I'm quite content to ask any of the legal team if they wanted to come in on this particular point, provide any advice. James,
I'll come in here just to say I think that's right. I think in terms of the technical remit, our advice would be that there's no reporting grounds engaged. But Andy might have a view on how the committee might wish to handle raising that concern.
Okay, thank you for that, Stephen. Mr. Sweeney, are you content with the explanation you just heard?
Yeah, that's helpful.
Okay, thank you. Andy?
Just to say, convener, that we could note that in our report that this is something that the lead committee might want to pick up in its consideration.
Yeah, no, that's happy to do that. Not an issue. You content with that, Mr. Sweeney?
Yeah, that's a helpful means of raising the concern. Thank you very much, Chair.
Okay, no problem. Thank you. Thank you for that. We'll go back to the agenda item number 6 and the SSIs. So the issue was SSIs 221, 210, 214, 220, 221, 222 and 225. Committee content with these instruments. So no members indicated that they're not content or that they wish to speak, and so we are agreed. Move on to agenda item number 7, I'm reconsidering instruments not subject to any parliamentary procedure. No points have been raised on SSIs 221, 226, 231, 232, 234 and 239. Committee content these instruments. No member has indicated that they're not content or that they wish to speak, and so we're agreed. Agenda item number 8 is the legacy paper, and we're considering the Delegated Powers and Law Reforms Session 5 legacy paper. Whilst the committee will look at the legacy paper in more detail as part of its planning work in the coming months, I wonder if at this point we simply note it for now, and therefore does the committee agree to thank members of the Session 5 Delegated Powers and Law Reform Committee for the legacy paper, and also to consider the report as part of its work programme discussions at future meeting.
Convener, I'm very content with that approach. We'll get a chance to speak about this later. And I just wonder, I'm saying this in public, I've only just thought of it, but wonder if it would be nice to for the committee to write to the previous convener and thank him for his work, Mr. Bill Bowman.
Now, Graham, I think that's a nice gesture, and I'd be content for our committee to do such a, to do that. So I think certainly Bill was an excellent convener of this committee. So no members indicated that they're not content, and so we are agreed. I will now move the meeting into private. Thank you very much.